Good afternoon. Today I wanted to talk about safety, and do you know what you would do in an emergency? Hi, I'm Kathy. And this is Steve. In 2019, we started planning our retirement and realized that we both wanted to travel and see the U.S. in an RV. So we started our adventure with Fate, Fortune, Fun. We packed up our fun mover and started planning weekend adventures and vacations to learn more about the RV lifestyle. Please subscribe and click the notification button so you can follow us as we continue this journey to retirement and beyond.
I saw a video last weekend about other RVers who do full-time who have a lot of options for how they handle their emergency situations, specifically remembering where you are, what site you're in, what's the address of the park that you're in, what's the nearest crossroads, all of those things. As part-timers, I don't always remember, so I can imagine if you're full-timing, what are you going to remember? The other thing that I wanted to talk about is a lot of us travel with pets. We travel with a dog. We have three, but we usually only bring one because our space is so small. And so what would you do if there was an emergency with your pet? What would you do if your pet got out? How are you going to handle it? So I started doing a lot of Googling. As far as emergencies for where you are and where you're located and things like that, the video that I watched had an amazing magnetic emergency contact that you could write on it with dry erase and erase it and keep it up to date, that you could put on your fridge if you had a residential fridge. We don't. So I'm going to copy what they did and put it into on a piece of paper and then seal it with my heat gun. And so it'll be in laminated paper so I can hang it somewhere in the RV. I will put the link below in the description of the video that I saw and what they use, because her magnet was amazing and I don't want to repeat it and I don't want to copy it because that's not cool. But what I did find is a company called Crafts for Rescue. Is that what it is? Crafts for Canine Rescue. And it's a woman who does crafts and does them because she loves crafting, and then a portion of the money or some of the money goes to rescues, which I love, having volunteered at a shelter. And so I ordered these the other day and they just came in this morning. And let me get the one that I already opened because the tape's easier to peel back, I think. Here we go. They're really cool. I bought two of these, one for the car and one for the RV, because if we go on excursion. So basically it's a tube and it says dogs on board in open in emergency. There's a piece of plastic around here that I need to pull off with this tab that I don't want to do until I hang it up. And then there's Velcro on either end, and then this side is sealed and it has dog information on side and has her little logo. And on this side, just for shipping, she has it turned this way. So what you would do is unscrew the cap, and then inside she's got a piece of a clip on a plastic thing that you could wrap around something, and I'll tell you why in a moment. And then this gray emergency paper. And so if you were always in the same area, you might want to put all this information in. You know, your pet name, your name, address, phone number, your pet identification, what you feed it, who your vet is, the last day they went to the vet, any meds that your dog's on. Because we travel so much, I'm going to modify this. And if I come up with a great format, I'll add it into the description later. But what I want to do is the same thing, is I'm going to make it she has a PDF, same company. You can download a PDF. So I'm going to look at that, see if it works for me. And then I'm going to put it into my laminator and laminate it, because the first tube that lives here in the rig, obviously if the dog's on board, you're going to need this information. The other tube I'm going to put into our car that we tow, and we'll use it when we go on excursions. And one of the things that we'll have in there is a place to mark the campground, the location, the phone number of the campground, all of that information. So if we're out without the dog and something happens to us, EMS knows we have a dog in our RV. And if we're with the dog, then they know that we have a dog. Because unfortunately, a lot of times what happens if you're in a car crash, the dog gets out and then they run. And so we don't want that to happen. So I'll put all that back in the tube. You end up screwing it back on like this, so it's really easy to open and close in an emergency situation. And then these are pieces of Velcro, and depending on your car seats or where you want to hang it, it's actually meant to go on the side of a crate. We don't have a crate permanently set up in our living space, so I have found a place up above where we store our paper towels that I'm gonna probably Velcro it on with, using, you know, our famous, you know, good old fashioned two-sided Velcro. I'll put a strip on the wall there and a strip, and then have it turned so that you can peel it off so I can keep it up to date. And also you'll be able to see open in case of emergency. So I really like this. The company name is Crafts for Canine Rescue. And I will put links about them below, and so that you can go and see if this is something that you want to do to help keep yourself and your pet safe. I'll put the link about how you can do it for yourself with medical information. But I really wanted to talk about the dogs, because I know our dogs are a valuable part of our life, and I would hate to have something happen to them when we're traveling. So hopefully you can think about it. Oh, I know, I forgot to say, why does this have a loop? Because the way she made this is that you can stuff your identifying information and a slip lead in there. Sorry, I've got the windows open on a gorgeous day and my bubble wrap is blowing. Okay, so you could put a slip lead in here too, and then snap this around the slip lead, snap it in, and then pull it all out together. So what some of the recommendations that I've seen is always keep a current picture in case your dog does get lost, that you can have a nice lost and found thing made. All your vet information up to date. Make sure if you're traveling with a pet, make sure if you have a pet, you've microchipped them. That is a lifesaver, because all vets, all shelters, all rescue places can scan it and let you know, and then get your animal back to you. If you travel a lot, make sure you keep your pet information up to date so that if your animal gets out, they have a way of contacting you. Most of the time, they're going to give you a phone call. But make sure your address is up to date, and make sure you make a note that you travel and that you live full time or you live part time, so that you can get your furry friend or other animal back to you in case there's an emergency. So I hope you find this video helpful. Hope you find this video helpful. Subscribe, hit that thumbs up notification bell so you can see what other videos we put out. And I hope all of us put something like this in our rigs and in our vehicles, and I hope no one ever needs it. Thanks. While you look at some photos, I thought I'd add a few items I forgot to mention. The dog emergency tubes come with a form inside that you can fill out with contact information, or you can go to their website and download one for free. They're both slightly different. I modified them again because they didn't have information specific for RVing on it. And after I did that, I laminated them to put into the tube. A helpful hint is, once you laminate, if you roll it up real tight, you can use some scotch tape to keep them tightly rolled, and that will help get them in and out of that tube easier. The magnet I was talking about with the emergency contact information is from You, Me, and the RV, and they're on YouTube, and they also have a blog page and a URL. So I've posted that in the descriptions. It's in their 10 Tips for Full-Time RV Life blog post. I hope you enjoyed all these tips, and we'll see you next time. Bye.